Hello, travel friends. Today we are going to travel to California and read a book about our beloved animal. Tales from History, a Sea Otter to the Rescue. It was a summer day in 2001. There was a new sea otter at an aquarium in California. The sea otter's name was Tula. Tula was a grown-up sea otter, about 5 years old. She was sick because of cat litter that had been dumped into the ocean. Tula needed medicine every day to stay healthy. The aquarium rescues sick sea otters because they're endangered. Say, endangered. That means they are at risk of disappearing forever. There are only about 3,000 wild sea otters living in California. The aquarium took good care of Tula. She quickly settled in her new home. She liked to make the staff chase her in the water. Soon after, a rescued baby sea otter was brought into the aquarium. A baby sea otter is called a pup. The pup was an orphan. No one knew what happened to his mother. He was only 2 weeks old. This was much too young for a pup to be on his own. In the past, some of the aquarium staff had raised sea otters. The humans had become parents for orphaned pups. When the pups were ready to return to the ocean, the staff put tags on the pups' flippers. This way, the aquarium could track the otters in the wild. However, very few of these sea otters lived long in the wild. Maybe it was because they spent too much time with the humans. This time, the staff had an idea. What if they gave the new orphan pup to Tula? She was old enough to be a mother. No one knew what would happen if they paired a pup with another sea otter. Would Tula raise the pup as her own? The pup floated on his back. He didn't know how to swim. Tula swam up to him. She reached toward the pup with her front paws. Then she pulled him onto her chest, just like any mother otter would do. Tula had adopted the pup. Tula was a good mother. She opened clamshells and shared them with the pup. When the pup was ready, Tula taught him how to swim. She pulled him along in the water and encouraged him to use his flippers. She taught him to dive too. Sea otters have to dive to find their food. They like to eat shellfish, such as clams and crabs that live on the ocean floor. Tula showed the pup how to open a hard shell. She put a rock on her chest. Then she hit the shell against the rock until the shell cracked. She even taught the pup how to make sure a crab couldn't pinch his nose. Sea otter's fur keeps it warm and dry in the water. The fur must always stay clean. So Tula spent many hours every day cleaning the pup's fur. Then Tula showed him how to groom his fur. She rubbed and licked her own fur. She turned over and over in the water. When the pup was about 6 months old, he was ready to return to the ocean. The staff tracked the pup with a tag. They watched him grow up in the wild and have many pups of his own. Tula had taught the pup to be a great sea otter. She had done what no sea otter at the aquarium had done before. Tula stayed at the aquarium to continue taking her medicine. She raised 12 more pups. She went from being rescued by the aquarium staff to rescuing other sea otters. There are now many sea otters who raise orphan pups at the aquarium. A young boy heard about Tula. His dad was a lawmaker in California. He asked his dad to write a law to protect sea otters. The law passed in 2006. It allows people to donate money to the endangered sea otters. People have donated more than $3 million thanks to Tula. The law helps scientists who study sea otters. This way, the scientists can learn how to protect them in the wild. Tula lived to be 15 or 16 years old. She was always busy raising pups or just having fun. Tula had no idea she was the most important sea otter in the aquarium's history. Facts about sea otters. Tula was a southern sea otter. They live along the coast of California. Sea otters are the largest member of the weasel family. Sea otters can hold their breath for up to 5 minutes. Sea otters sleep while floating on their backs. Humans have about 100 southern hairs on their heads. Sea otters can have up to 1 million hairs per square inch. That is the most fur per square inch of any animal. How you can help sea otters. Throw away your trash properly. Litter can pollute the ocean. Write your lawmakers and ask them to help protect sea otters and other marine life. If you ever see a sea otter, keep your distance. They may be cute, but touching them is unsafe for the otter and for you. If you have a pet cat, don't flush the cat litter down the drain. Cat litter contains bacteria that make sea otters sick. Spread the word about sea otters. Tell your family and friends how they can help too.